Hello friends, welcome again to another session of our meet and greet as part of the Cross Culture Recitals and Concerts. Today we are very excited to have Surabhi Vijay with us. Surabhi joins us from Northern California, the Bay Area. Surabhi is actually a friend of mine as well. She is a singer, performer, and a teacher. And actually she specializes in Indian classical music, film music, loves musical storytelling, and experimenting with cross-cultural music. So she is the perfect ambassador for our cross-culture platform. So Surabhi grew up in a musically inclined family, actually, and she started her training from her mother, Padma Vijayaraghavan, an accomplished disciple of Padma Bhushan Sri T.V. Gopalakrishnan. She then transitioned from a career in engineering to pursue music and has since founded Carnatic California, you know, something that I'm very interested to talk to you about as well, Surabhi, an endeavor to popularize Carnatic music from Southern India and make it more accessible to a larger audience. She is also a certified, she's certified in world music and in music production as well from the prestigious Berklee College of Music. And currently she is continuing her advanced Carnatic music training from the eminent Kalaimamani K.N. Shashikiran. Welcome, Surabhi. Very, very nice to have you again today on our platform. How are you doing?
It's my pleasure and honor to be here, Ranjini. I'm doing great. Thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited.
It's my absolute pleasure. You know, as I was mentioning, you know, I've been following you for like the last several, like at least 4 years now. And, you know, I was thinking before our meet and greet, like, you know, there's so many of your workshops that you've organized in the past and we've attended it. And, you know, it's kind of surreal to now have you in our platform. And I was thinking how nice, you know, what a great way to, you know, showcase you in our cross-culture platform. Thank you so much. But I was wondering, Surabhi, if you could maybe, you know, kind of walk us through a little bit about your journey, you know, sort of how you started off in Carnatic music, which is, you know, Indian, South Indian classical music. And you've, you know, you've totally transitioned also in the cross-cultural space. There's lots of different initiatives I know you're working on. So just wondering if you could share some of that with our audience. Thank you.
Yeah, I would love to. So like you said, I just got lucky. Lottery, I guess, the birth lottery, that I grew up in a family where my mother was trained very, very well, thoroughly. She used to give concerts, and my great grandfather, her grandfather, was very good friends with Madhura Somu. And my great grandfather would tell my mom, you know, that I don't have anything big to ask from you. I only want you to sing like MS. That's it.
To ask. Very, very simple request.
Exactly. Right? No big deal. And Madhura, I've heard that from my grandmother, that Madhura Somu assured my great-grandfather not to worry about my mom, that she would do really well.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So she comes from a great place of knowledge and training. And I was just lucky to grow up in that environment with her, being taught by her, seeing her teach a lot of people. And I think that's where my subconscious instinct to teach comes from. Then I used to work, study late nights with the radio playing in the background. And that's when AIR used to play wonderful Hindustani music, Pandit Vishwamohan Bhatt, at midnight. And somehow that caught my soul. So that's how I also started wanting to train in Hindustani music. Then just life took its course. I did biomedical engineering. I was working in New York for a couple of years, and I always wanted to music, but it somehow was never enough. So when I made a transition to California, which is, you know, full of Indian musicians and arts and such a supportive environment too, I said, you know, why not try to half a bit of courage and half a bit of crazy is what I I said, I'm going to, you know, make the plunge into music. And that's how Carnatic California was born. Yeah. I think just my background as an engineer and having worked here gives me a kind of a certain perspective to working with people that I really enjoy. And we have a huge community now of you know, music students and music lovers. And I teach classes, we do workshops, like you said, which we've been so happy to have the likes of you and your incredibly talented kids join. And really just, I think I just love to experiment. So I'm at a loss to explain what we'll do next because I don't know, but something unique will come up and that's what we'll be after.
No, I think it's amazing, Surabhi, and, you know, and I've also seen, I've always, you know, first of all, I always like the name Carnatic California. I think it's a beautiful alliteration. And I've also seen a lot of the work that you've done with the school and your students. And what I found very interesting, you know, even when we had you back in May for the, you know, the World Culture Day, you know, all the different, you know, sort of cross-cultural experiments, if you will, that you challenge your students and yourself to do. I was wondering, you know, would it be okay for you to kind of give us a little brief overview on some of these different efforts that you've been pursuing as part of Carnatic California? Because I think one of, as you know, one of the efforts behind the cross-culture concerts and recitals is to get folks to sort of step out of their comfort zone and embrace, you know, if not just music of another kind, but at least try to explore sort of what's at the interface at least. And I think a lot of what you're doing is very, very interesting. And, you know, I wanted our audience to kind of get an idea and maybe go visit the Carnatic California YouTube page as well.
Yeah, definitely. I think when I started teaching, one of my motivations, and that's something that I just discovered incidentally, because I was, you know, just teaching a friend, they just requested me and I, okay, I really don't know teaching, I can sing, but we can kind of walk through it together. And then slowly I realized that it was extremely fulfilling for me and for the person at the end of it. And then that's how it grew. It grew with, you know, a few people who knew me from college or who knew I would sing and said, you know, why don't we try? And why don't we try? And now we have about 70 people who learn. I think I have 3 years old students to 55 year old students. And one of my largest priorities when I started teaching was that there are a lot of avenues for children to learn music systematically, but not so much for adults. And that's a pity because so many of us have learned music as kids and then life just happens and we have this long gap, but then we want to go back to that place because music does something for our soul, right? Music is about music, but it's kind of your companion that was there when nobody else was. You listen to a song, you know which point in your life you listened to that song, right? And what happened, maybe you even remember what clothes you were wearing, you know, that memory is that specific. You don't need equipment.
Absolutely.
You don't need space to sing. It's just you and music. And so people want to get back, or people who've always wanted to learn as children but never had the opportunity.
Right.
You know? Right. So all it takes is just that sincerity. And a lot of people have a fear that, oh, maybe I don't have a singing voice. Maybe it's too late. And that's how I started. And now I also have a huge troupe of little humans that I absolutely enjoy. Right. And I'm always looking for ways on how to connect with them, right? Music should not be a formal thing that they do outside their regular existence. It shouldn't be something else. It has to kind of fuse and become a way of life. And especially for us, we are in California. The kids grow up in an American, fairly American environment. And I think people tend to think of it as, oh, this is my American existence. This is my Indian existence.
You're so right about that.
Inclusive things, right?
Right.
So when we appeal to people's sensibilities in some way, I think it seems to get bridged. So I used to do workshops with young artists, older artists, interviews with musicians. Then I started doing a learner series on YouTube, which I initially thought, you know, my students come to class, they record the entire class from start to finish, but they like to have one piece for reference. And when they go to the virtual world, now there's so many versions that many students sometimes have a hard time choosing which version,
right.
You know.
Totally.
And even a Vidwan's version may not be right for a beginner student. So I started doing learner series where it's just simple versions people can learn from. And then the online community seemed to reinforce that a lot of people were deriving benefit from that. Then I started doing, you know, tutorials on the varisais and all that. And, you know, it's easy to visualize swaras or tones when you know that they are frequencies. So then we started including graphs and those things started happening. Mm-hmm. On. Mm-hmm. And we have a concert, two concerts actually that we do every year, one of which is called the open mic, where every year I try to find a new avenue to explore Carnatic music with. And that's how last year, when things, the pandemic really hit for the first time and we were all left in the lurch and still navigating the virtual world, was born this concept called Carnatic Journeys to the West.
Yes.
And my idea was, how do you explore Carnatic music in the context of global, worldwide music or Western music? All my students were, or most of my students were actually really shocked and scared of the topic, because we've seen Carnatic music in the context of Indian music, film music, Hindustan music, North Indian music, all of that, it's more familiar. And then by the end of it, a lot of people, even in the video webcast that we had, and you can see it on Facebook and YouTube, a lot of students expressed how they were surprised by how many ideas they had, how better they did for themselves compared to what they thought. And at the end of that particular show, so many, especially the kids, they just couldn't stop. They kept thinking, oh, this piece by Maroon 5 really matches with this raga. Oh, that piece by Ed Sheeran sounds like this. And it was incredible, because they realized that them being a choir singing student and them being a Carnatic music student is not two different contradictory things, but they're actually integrated, right? The swarams are different. We call it different things. The jargon is different, but it's the same. And that's what I think I derive the thrill out of. And I think even personally, I was telling about Carnatic and Hindustani music. And much earlier, when I would sing to a Carnatic music crowd, people would say, oh, you have a Hindustani influence, don't you? And when I would sing in front of the Hindustani crowd, people would say, oh, you're from the South, aren't you? And it frustrated me a little bit for a while. And now I've grown to realize that that's my identity. Those are the influences that, you know, shape you as a musician. I've grown up listening to Metallica, Bryan Adams, all these people, and I can enjoy Maroon 5 right now after a 3-hour Sanjay Subramaniam concert, but it all works together. It's all the same.
Exactly. And, you know, which is exactly why I think, you know, having you on our platform for this is so perfect. You know, this is kind of exactly what we want to, you know, I mean, it started off with, you know, trying to feature artists, you know, who are practicing music of another culture, who spent like decades doing this, whether it's Indian music or Indonesian or what have you, you know, people spending decades going to another country, learning music. So, you know, it started off with that idea, and trying to bring people together and give them a platform. So to encourage more people to embrace music that's not theirs. And I think now it's kind of evolved a little bit to your point. And I think I love what you're saying about, you know, getting folks to think about, you know, Western music also from a raga standpoint. And I know you have several different videos, you know, on YouTube in Carnatic California YouTube channel. Very, very interesting. I encourage everyone to go and take a look. I promise you it's going to be very interesting to learn the thought process, whether it's Adele or Maroon 5. You know, I just love the connection that you made with the ragas, and also notating each of these Harry Potter theme song, you know, notating it in swaras. I mean, just amazing. I really love this. So transitioning a little bit, Surabhi, into your performance, which you're going to premiere shortly. Without giving it away, because we want, you know, folks to see it, but very curious to know, I know we talked a little bit before, but I'm very curious to know what your arrangement on this has been and what your thought process was for this.
Oh, yeah. I have to be honest and tell you that when you initially called me with this idea and pitched this idea to me, I was like a kid in Candyland, because this is like the cool kids say, this is my jam.
Absolutely.
Use it. So, like you said, without giving too much away, the idea has been to take Carnatic music in as many different directions as possible, and to let people know that I've presented a few journeys, a journey, you know, within India, to Persia, to Chinese music, to, of course, American music, a little bit in Ireland, all these different, Egypt, all these different places. But then as we were speaking, the ideas don't end because they keep going. So it'll be really cool if, you know, after seeing the show, people in your audience come up with, you know, their own presentations to which they feel like they can connect this music to that. And this all just feels the same. So I hope that people are inspired by the, you know, audiovisual story and the painting that we are going to paint, and that people try and do the same too.
I think it's very exciting. I cannot wait to watch this wonderful production. And, you know, I want to thank you for doing this. I know amidst you have a little one as well at home. And, you know, to have done something like this is just fabulous. One question also I wanted to ask you, Surabhi, both as a sort of a teacher and as a student of music, you know, what would you say to folks who've not had, like you were mentioning in the beginning, like adults, some of us like learned music and then we kind of left it, you know, because life happened. And then we kind of want to stay in touch. We don't have enough time to, you know, learn. So what would you recommend to folks like that? Would you recommend that they, you know, take some formal lessons and explore what their passion is? Or would you say just dabble? I've always wondered what kind of advice one would give to busy adults with, you know, children, teenagers, you know. What are your thoughts on this?
That's an interesting question, actually. I think consolidating from all the people I see, all the students that I meet and teach, and I've had joy and experience to work with, one thing I would definitely say, and for me, many times when I question, you know, why I left a full-time paying benefits, all the kind of those things that we want for in a job to do what I do, I'm reminded of all the times that I've had so many adults typically go through very difficult circumstances in life, but able to hang on because they're definitely doing music. The music class is the one thing that they won't miss. People plan a lot of things around that music. It's not to speak about music class itself, but it's about what that does to them somewhere on the inside, right? So I think perhaps it's a personal question on to whether they want to dabble or take lessons. But I don't think as adults that it's a question of, oh, do I want to get a certificate or pass a grade or perform an arangetram? The question to ask yourself is whether you want to be aware of what you're singing more, to have a community that sings with you and supports you and is critical and yet supportive and gives you platforms. So maybe you don't want to, you know, this is not a time in your life where you have other things going on. You're not looking for a big stage, but you do want opportunities and, you know, the joy of singing with people, interacting, understanding music across genres a little bit better. So I think if somebody is able to find the right guru for them, because that's important. Every teacher is different. Every student is different. And that rapport, that when it clicks, right? That's when the best magic happens. If they find that, then some form of musical instruction is always going to be very satisfying for somebody who even wants to dabble in music. All that it takes as an adult to learn is not really your starting level or your previous training, but some sort of sincerity and commitment to wanting to
be. Right. No, I think that's great advice, Surabhi. And then the other question I had is for folks who are, you know, trained, you know, as students or as upcoming professionals or professionals, you know, would you have something to say about, like, how can you encourage them to, you know, step outside their comfort zone, you know, especially, you know, I know we've talked about this a few times, you know, about, you know, Carnatic musicians, you know, trying to step out of their comfort zone. You know, any kind of advice you'd like to give anyone who's learned music of a particular kind that's classical, but asking them to step out of the comfort zone? A lot of them are a little, you know, like they don't want to try because they're concerned, you know, what kind of message it might send, or maybe they're not comfortable doing it. From your experience, is there something you would like to share to them?
Really, I'm really enjoying these questions, Ranjini, I have to say that. I think I see where you're coming from. I've interviewed in one of the famous musicians that I had the privilege to interview. I asked them this casual question that what other genres of music do you listen to? And I remember the artist very clearly and unequivocally stating that they absolutely didn't listen to any other form of music. And, you know, because they were very careful about the kind of sentiments that it would evoke in the public, you know. And I see the point, because the rasikas or the viewers and the audience, you have to stay true to them, right, as a musician, if you want to stay in the field. So I do see where they're coming from. But the blessing is the era that we live in, where there's so much of global exposure. When MS sang Meera Bhajan, it was out of the world at that time, because you couldn't really even hear Hindi easily if you, you know, wanted to. Now everybody is expect to pronounce it perfectly, because there's so much, you can just at a click of a button, there's so much experience. So I think stepping out of the comfort zone is a personal choice. You should do it to be authentic to yourself. If you want to do it as a musician, then you shouldn't really be nervous about what people will say, because then you're always going to end up with the regret of not knowing what happened. And these days, everybody is actually really very accepting and very happy to encourage great music and experimentation. And this is the blessing of the era that we live in. And maybe start with baby steps, find a community that kind of fosters you, supports you, will be critical but without being negative, and then launch into a bigger platform slowly. I think that's the balance also. But if you want to do it, you should. This is the blessing of the time.
No, and I think it's a beautiful message, Surabhi. And I certainly hope our series has encouraged, you know, many folks at different levels to experiment this. Thank you for saying this and sharing your thoughts, and, you know, also sharing your work with us in your performance that we're going to premiere very shortly. Want to thank you one more time. You know, if there is anything else you'd like to share with our audience, Ruby, I'd love to have you share that. But, you know, I know you have a little one waiting for you as well. So, yeah, you know, audience, please tune in. Don't leave just yet. You know, in just a few minutes, we're premiering this very different, unique performance by Surabhi in the cross-cultural platform. Stay tuned, follow her, you know, Karnataka California YouTube channel, and, you know, please do reach out to Surabhi or myself if you'd like to get in touch with her. Thank you again, Surabhi. You know, hope to see you sometime soon, you know, either down here in Southern California or up there in the Bay Area.
That would be lovely. Thank you so much, Ranjini, and to the entire Sayart Saras team. I know you have a huge team working behind you too, for giving this wonderful platform, not just to me. I've been following your work for a long time, and it's so inspiring. And music and organizations have been around for a long time, but still the how you so effortlessly managed to bring something so unique and fresh to the artists and to the audiences is so inspiring. So I'm totally so excited about the work that you do at Sayart Saras. Thank you for giving me the chance to be a small part of that.
Oh, the pleasure and honor is absolutely mine. Thanks again, Surabhi, and stay in touch, and hope to see you sometime soon. Thank you, audience. Bye.
Hello, welcome, namaskaram, and namaste to all the audience and rasikas tuning in today for the finale of the cross-culture concert series organized by Sayart Saras. This is Surabhi Vijay, and I will be your host, presenter, and music performer all rolled into one for this evening. This idea is so wonderfully conceptualized and executed by its curator and founder, Dr. Ranjini Ramachandar, when she approached me with this idea about a month back. I have to admit, I was thrilled like a kid in a candy store. Isn't this topic of cross-culture music as deep and wide and vast as the ocean itself? So join me and my students at Karnataka, California, across this concert where we tour throughout the world and make pit stops, riding in the vehicle of Indian classical music, both Carnatic and flavors of Hindustani Sangeet. When we say cross-culture, we need to look too much farther than our own home country, India, with its hotspot of languages, cuisines, cultures, religion, and more. So let's kick off the evening with a cross-country journey between the sultry and sandy desert lands of Rajasthan and the fertile deltas of Tamil Nadu, riding the vehicle of folk music. A simple ektara or single-stringed instrument in hand was all one needed to immerse oneself in folk music, often very simple tunes and even simpler words with deep, deep meaning, sung in the quintessential rural style of open-throated singing, free of the seeming refinement, modulations and brighas of Shastriya Sangeetam or Karnataka Sangeetam. After all, a rural person barely had the time or resources to take hours of riyaz, of formal training of music. So let's tap into the joys of a verse that is sung like a life breath popularly by tribes, right from the Malvi singers of Madhya Pradesh to the Manganiya tribes of Rajasthan, all the way to the Sufi Qawwals of Pakistan. With much awe, I have adapted that piece into the most iconic and enduring story of romantic separation, Virah. Here, our protagonist takes a one-way road from her Virah, which itself leads her to Viveka, a centering wisdom in the beautiful Melakarta Ragam, Vachaspati. The three V's seem meant to be Virah, Vivek, Vachaspati. Please enjoy this video as aired at Karnataka California's Open Mic 2021.
ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਸਾਡਾ ਕਲੀਆ ਜੀ ਨੇ ਉਲਕਣਾ, ਸਾਡਾ ਕਲੀਆ ਜੀ ਨੇ ਉਲਕਣਾ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਕਿਸੇ ਛੋੜਾ ਨਾ ਕਿਸੀ ਦੇ ਪੇਸ਼ ਆਵੇ, ਨਾ ਕਿਸੀ ਦੇ ਪੇਸ਼ ਆਵੇ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਸਜਣਾ ਤੇਰੇ ਬਿਨਾ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਪਰਾਤ ਪਰਾਤ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਪਰਾਤ ਪਰਾਤ, ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇੱਕ ਪਲ ਚੈਨ ਨਾ ਆਵੇ, ਪਰਾਤ ਪਰਾਤ, ਪਰਮੇਸ਼ਵਰਾ, ਪਰਾਤ ਪਰਾਤ। ओ सजना तेरे बिना, 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 सजना
Now that we've roamed the length of India, let's expand our horizons and make a trip to the Orient, China. Ask a child about China and back comes the reply, Kung Fu Panda, and the fond excitement of the adorable movie. As adorable as the movie was, the grand soundtrack by maestro Hans Zimmer serves as the perfect landscape for bamboo, kung fu, and surprise, surprise, every kind of Carnatic composition that exists. Don't believe me? Hear it for yourself, and no prizes for guessing the ragam. One of our own dearest favorites, Mohanam, as addressed in Carnatic, and Bhupali, as the Hindustani folks call it, also happens to be extremely popular with Chinese music. And in part two of this piece, having toured China, it's only right to now invite our gracious hosts home. You'll find a Chinese classic melody sitting side by side with some of our own Hindi classics. The Mandarin hit song titled The Wandering Songstress was first aired in the 1937 movie Street Angel and was featured in Academy Award winning director of international acclaim Ang Lee's movie recently in 2007. Paired with this are our own hits In Aankhon Ki Masti Ke from the movie Umrao Jaan released in 1981 and Dil Hum Hum Kare from Rudali in 1993. Coincidentally, both songs sung by sisters Asha Bhonsle and Lata Mangeshkar, respectively. Whether Hindi or Mandarin, it's quite shocking to notice the stunning resemblance in the meaning of the lyric across these three verses, reminding us that cross-culture as it may be, humans and emotions are a single thread running across, only separated by geography. Please enjoy Carnatic Kung Fu.
Swagatam Krishna Sharanagatam Krishna Swagatam Krishna Sharanagatam Krishna Madhurapuri Sadana Mridu Kadana Madhusudana Swagatam Krishna Sharanagatam Krishna
Thank you.
ಪರಮ ಶುಭ ಗುಣಲೋಲಾ ನೀರತಿ ಜಯ ಪ್ರದಶೀಲ ವರದ ಪ್ರಿಯ ರಂಗರಾಯತಿ ಮಾಜಿತ ಭರಗಾಯತಿ ಸರಸೀಜಾ ಸರಜನನಿ
ಮಸ್ತಾನಿ ಹಸಾರೂ
Music was released 1937, 1981 and 1993. Boy oh boy, that's also a bit of a historical journey, isn't it? Now around that same time in the West, a blockbuster movie called The Love Story came out, featuring a beautiful melody that still lingers today called Where Do I Begin, sung by Andy Williams. Now let the 70s Western love story be coming back to India, and especially South India, if you grew up listening to your grandmom's spiritual tales and stories, you must be familiar with the love story of deities Meenakshi and Sundaresha, wouldn't you? Now, have you heard Periyasami Thuran's Carnatic composition called Devi Niye Thunaindaragam Keeravani, which talks about this very same love story? Do you see how all the pieces of this puzzle add up? So here is presenting Where Do I Begin, Keeravani, by my student at Karnataka, California, Aarti Ashok. Please enjoy.
Sweet love story that is older than the sea. The simple truth about the love he brings to me. Where do I start? Like the summer rain that cools the pavement with a patent leather shine. There'll never be another love another time. He came into my life and made my living fine.
Devi.
Ma ba da ni da ni.
Papa gaga, papa da pa mama di ri, mama pa ma gaga sa sa, gaga ma ga di ri ni ni ni. How long does it last? Can love be measured by the hours in a day? I had no answers now, but this much I can say. I'm going to lead him till the stars burn away.
With the success of that love story comes the need to relax. So here comes poet and philosopher from Persia, from way back in the 10th century, Omar Khayyam, to meet Tamil lady Saint Andal to provide the same. Here is Persian Bihag, different languages, but one love.
पैमोना बेदे कि खूमोरस्तम पैमोना बेदे कि खूमोरस्तम मनोश के चश्मे मस्ते आरस्तम मनोश के चश्मे मस्ते आरस्तम बेदे बेदे कि खूमोरस्तम पैमोना बेदे कि खूमोरस्तम ஒருத்தி மகனாய் பிறந்து ஒருத்தி மகனாய் பிறந்து ஓரிரவில் ஒருத்தி மகனாய் ஒழித்து வளர ஒருத்தி மகனாய் பிறந்து ஓரிரவில் ஒருத்தி மகனாய் ஒழித்து வளர ஒருத்தி மகனாய் பிறந்து பேமுனா வேதே கி கூமோரஸ்தம் மனோஷுக்கு चश्मे मस्ते आरस्तम वेदे वेदे कि खूमोरस्तम पैमोना वेदे कि खूमोरस्तम தரிக்கிலானாகி தான் திங்கு நினைத்து ஆ கருகிலானாகி தான் திங்கு நினைத்து கருத்தை பிழைப்பித்த கம்சன் வயிற்றில் கருத்தை பிழைப்பித்த கம்சன் வயிற்றில் நெருப்பென நின்ற நெடுமாலே நெருப்பென நின்ற நெருப்பென நின்ற நெடுமாலே ஜஷ்மத் கே பாகுவே குதன் மேமுனா ரோயத் பகுலா பாய் சமன் மேமுனா குல் ரோபகுனி த்வர க்வர போயே குனி பாலாலே அசர் பேவதன் கிகோமோரஸ்தம் பேமோனா பேதி கிகோமோரஸ்தம் நீ சனீத பண்ணி சகமா பகமக கமபனீத பமத பமகமக ஆமகமா பபமக கமமக கரி சி நி சனி நி ச நீ நீ ச நீ நீ ச நீ ச நீ நீ ச நீ நீ ச கக நீ நீ ச மம்ம ம நீ நீ ச ப ப ப க ம ப நி 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 ப நி ச ப நி ச நீ த ப ம ப க ம க க ரி ச நீ ச நீ த ப ம ப க ம க க ரி ச நீ ச நீ நீ த ப ம ப க ம க க ரி ச நீ ச நெருப்பென நின்ற நெடுமாலே உன்னை அறுத்து வந்தோம் பறை தருதியாகில் அறுத்து வந்தோம் பறை தருதியாகில் திருத்தக்க செல்வமும் சேவகமும் யாம் பாடி திருத்தக்க செல்வமும் சேவகமும் யாம் பாடி வருத்தமும் தீர்ந்து மகிழ்ந்தேலூர் எம் பாவாய் வருத்தம்
With all that zipping and zapping across countries, history and time, America is yet to make an appearance, and appear it must. So here is R&B soul chartbuster from 2019, The Blinding Lights, performed by The Weeknd. Now, let's come back to Indian music for a second. Which of our own ragas has the power and brilliance of Blinding Lights, of A Thousand Suns? Maybe Madhyamavati? Let's check out The Blinding Lights of Madhyamavati.
I've been on my own for long enough. Maybe you can show me how to love. Maybe I'm going through withdrawals. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on with just a touch. Maybe I look around. Sin City's cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone. And I said, ooh, I'm blinded by the lights. No, I can't sleep, but did I feel your touch? I said, ooh, I'm drowning in the night. Oh, when I'm like this, you're the one I trust.
Pani sare ma pani sare sani pa mari sani sare ma pani sare mari sani pa mari sani pani sani sare sare mari ma pa mari sani ni sare sare mari ma pa ma pani pa mari sa sare mari ma pa ma pani pani sani sare ni sare ma re sani sare re ni ni sa sa pa pani ni ma ma pa pa re re ma ma sa sa Rima pani sa pani ma pa rima sa 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 pani ma pa rima sa 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 pani ma pa rima sa pa chu kamakshi pavani.
I'm just calling back to let you know. I could never say it on the phone. I'll never let you go this time.
Oh, Baba. Kamakshi pavani papashamani paanchu. Paanchu kamakshi pavani papa shamani ambaba chuka makshi pavani papa shamani pa chuka makshi pavani papa shamani pa Chukamakshi pavani.
Alright, now comes the dance and the groove part of this evening's show. Are you ready? So here comes a troop of little humans, my adorable little students as adorable as the minions of Despicable Me, which is where this song featured. Most of you would have already guessed which song this is, I think. Yes, Happy by Pharrell Williams. Only this time, Carnatic Happiness, performed by Arav, Anvita, Sahasra, Sahana, Nirvi and Tan.
Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like a room without you.
Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like happiness is the truth.
Because I'm happy,
come along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
So I'm ga-ga-ga, ba-ba-ba-di-di-da.
Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like a room without a roof.
Because I'm happy, come along
if you feel like
happiness is the truth.
Because I'm happy, come along if you know what happiness is to you.
Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Bring me down.
Cannot.
Because I'm happy, come along if you know what happiness is to you.
Because I'm happy, come along
if you feel like
that's what you wanna do.
Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like happiness is the truth.
Because I'm happy,
come along if you know what happiness is to you. Because I'm happy, come along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Through the course of this journey, we've roamed India, Persia, China, America, and ridden back and forth several times in a time machine. Now, how about we finish off with one journey that's a lot like the famous book Around the World in 80 days, except let's do it in Carnatic tunes. So here is one final journey that check us past all the little spots that we've left. Ireland and Britain and the pyramids of Egypt, Harry Potter and Muthuswami Dikshitar and Kamal Hassan. So, signing off with Around the World in Carnatic Tunes, performed by Aishwarya, Akshay, Prerna, Sneha, Shriram and Harsha.
कौसल्या सुप्रजा राम पूर्वा संध्या प्रवर्तते उत्तिष्ठ नरशार्दूल कर्तव्यं दैवमान्धिकम्
शक्ति सहित गणपतिं शंकरादि सेवितं विरक्त सकल मुनिवर सुरराज विरुत गुरुगुणं भक्तादि पोषकं भवसुतं विनायकं भक्तादि पोषकं भवसुतं विनायकं भक्तिमुतिगणभूषितगण्डतपरभुजमायामि शक्तिसहितगणपतिं शङ्करादिसेवितं विभक्तसकलमुनिवरसुरराजविरुतगुरुगुणं शक्तिसहितगणपतिं 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 गणपतिं गणपतिम्
There's a fire starting in my heart, reaching a fever pitch and is bringing me out the dark. Finally, I can see you crystal clear. Go ahead and sell me out and I'll lay your ship bare. The scars of your love remind me of us. They keep me thinking that we almost had it all. The scars of your love, they leave me breathless. I can't help feeling we could have had it all. Count your blessings to find what you look for. Turn my sorrow into treasured gold. Pay me back in kind and reap just what you sow. We could have had it all.
இருதயம் அடிக்கடி இருந்தது என் வேணா, என் கதை எழுதிட மறுக்குது என் வேணா.
பதபம 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 பதபம
சுருதி லயமும் ஒன்று சேர
का।
we will rock you.
With that, we come to the end of this musical journey across cultures. If you enjoyed this kind of music and would like to listen to some more, you can visit Surabhi Vijay at YouTube or Karnati California on YouTube as well as Facebook for more such videos. My sincere thanks and gratitude also on behalf of my Karnati California community to Ranjini and the entire Sai Arts Aras organization for giving us this fantastic platform. Take care, everyone, and onwards and upwards.